Hello dear students, welcome back to the session. And yes, now we are going to read the poem and will know about the explanation. So let's start with the poem. As I have told you, this poem is in this poem the speaker is a school boy, and he is very much attracted with many things. And let's start read out the poem. First of all, I am going to read out the first incident. Listen carefully and try to read with me. When the gong sounds 10 in the morning and I walk to school by our lane, every day I meet the hawker crying, "Bangles, crystal bangles." There is nothing to hurry him on. There is no road he must take, no place he must go to, no time when he must come home. I wish I were a hawker, spending my day in the road crying, "Bangles, crystal bangles." Yes, dear students, as I told you in my previous video, that first of all, he met to a bangle hawker. So in this stanza, you will get these difficult words. Like first word is your gong, which means an object made of metal which gives sound when struck. Most of the times you have seen in the temples. Then hawker. Hawker means a person who travels and shouts to sell goods. Many times you see vegetable hawkers in your streets. Crystal, a jewel which looks clear and transparent just like eyes. Okay. If you have ever seen bangles in your mom's hand, then obviously you will find that what is the meaning of crystal. And vendor, a street salesman. Okay, so let's read the let's know about the explanation. So when the gong sounds 10 in the morning and I walk to school by a lane. So in this line, the child said that when the gong struck, bell struck and made a sound to declare the first part of the day, it was 10 o'clock. He said that this was also the time for him to go to school. It means the timing of the school was 10 o'clock. And every day I meet the hawker crying, "Bangles, crystal bangles." I walk to school by our lane. So he said that this was also the time for him to go to school. And on his way to school, he used to watch a salesman who would shout, "Bangles, crystal bangles," to sell his bangles in his lane. Over all the daily, he found a bangle hawker there. There is nothing to hurry him on. There is no road to he must take. In this stanza, the schoolboy is describing the routine of hawker. Okay, bangle hawker. And he says, while looking at him, the child had a thought that the vendor was free. He was in no hurry to reach anywhere. Okay, there was no hurry for him. And unlike the child who had to reach school on time and come back home. Obviously, the school has prescribed time limit in which you have to reach the school and you will come back from the school. But as the school is bounded with a time, but this hawker has no time limit. He thought that the bangle seller was free of any time constraint, time foundations. Place foundation mean he was free to move to any place unlike him. So he felt as if he was under strict observation and the vendor was enjoying complete freedom. As he saw the bangle hawker was moving here and there without any foundation, so he was attracted from them and he was thinking that the vendor was enjoying complete freedom. So what he wished, "I wish I were a hawker, spending my day in the road crying, 'Bangles, crystal bangles.'" So after watching the bangle hawker who was moving freely in the street, thus the boy was saying he was so impressed by his freedom that he wished to be a hawker. He wished to move freely and shout just like him in the streets. Okay, so in this first part of the day, he was attracted by the bangle hawker because he was moving freely here and there and he also wanted to be like him. Next. When at 4 in the afternoon I come back from the school, I can see through the gate of that house the gardener digging the ground. okay, now here is the next part of the day. And but he saw there at, and what was the time? Time was at 4 o'clock. Okay, so here the word digging, which means break up the soil or earth with hands or tool. So the child, after coming back from school at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, noticed the gardener through the gate of the house. Okay, when he enters the house and he just moved back to close the door, what he sees? Yes, he saw the gardener. Okay, and what he was doing, he would peep out and notice him digging soil. Okay, what was he doing? He was digging the ground. And what he says then? He does what he likes with his spade. He soils his clothes with dust. Nobody takes him to task if he gets baked in the sun or gets wet. I wish I were a gardener digging away at the garden with nobody to stop me from digging. Okay, so what he wished here, student, first of all, look at the word meanings. Here is the word spade, which means a sharp edged tool used for digging and cutting. Okay, next is baked in the sun, this phrase, which means heated because of excessive sunlight, excessive sun exposure. Then here is digging away, means to devote serious and consistent effort. Okay, so let's move on to the explanation. And he said here the child was attracted by his freedom. Whose freedom? Gardener's freedom. Okay, the person who take care of the garden, nurseries, his freedom to be in the dust, because he was completely smeared with the dust, and do the things of the choice with his tools. Okay, with the gardening tools, he was doing the work of his choice. He thought that the gardener had the freedom to dirty his cloth with soil and play with his tools, stay in the sun for longer hours, get wet with sweat or do anything, and he was not getting any punishment for all this. Whereas if he would have been punished for all this, obviously whenever a child goes to parks to play or goes to the garden, obviously he always smeared with the dust and got dirty, and whenever he comes back to the home, obviously he got punished, or he will be scolded by his mother because of the dirty clothes and dirty body. So now that's why he was attracting from the gardener, because according to the boy, the gardener has complete freedom for getting dirtier, and he thought that the gardener had the freedom to dirty his cloth with soil, and he can play with the tools, and he can stay in the sun for a long time, and he will not be punished for all these things. Yet as a boy, I have been punished for all these things. So I wish I were a gardener digging away at the garden with nobody to stop me from digging. So completely unaware of the hardship of that worker. Okay, life of gardener is not an easy, because gardening work is also require lots of physical strength. Okay, so he was completely unaware of all the hardships, all the difficulties which is faced by the gardener, the caretaker of the garden. But he was attracted to be a gardener, to do things of his choice, and no one around to stop him. He was just attracted from the freedom, because according to the boy, that person is doing the work according to his will only, and nobody is there to stop him. As always, a mother or his teacher always stay with him to punish him or to stop him. Next, move on to the next stanza. Just as it gets dark in the evening and my mother sent me to bed, I can see through my open window the watchman walking up and down. The lane is dark and lonely, and the street lamp stands like a giant with one red eye in its head. Dear students, we have read about street hawker who was selling the bangles. Next, we have seen the gardener. Now it's time for, it is the night time. Okay, it is the time for sleeping. But before to go to the bed, he was seeing something. And what was that? the watchman. Okay, so walking up and down, it is a phrase which means to move back and forth, move back and come from again from one side to the other. Okay, he was moving from one side to the another. Giant means an imaginary superhuman. Superhuman. So look at the stanza explanation. What the child, what the schoolboy wants to say. Just as it gets dark in the evening, at night his mother would send him to sleep in his room. Okay, and where there used to be an open window. So there is an open window in his room, and from there the boy would notice a watchman walking here and there from one side to the other in the dark, lonely street. He also had a lamp in his hand. Okay, lamp stands like a giant, and which looked to him like a superhuman with a red eye in its head. A light of the lamp seems to him like a superhuman with a red eye in its head. Okay, so the last lines. The watchman swings his lantern and walks with his shadow at his side and never once goes to bed in his life. I wish I were a watchman, walking the street all night, chasing the shadows with my lantern. So here the swings, which means to move from one side to another, and chasing means pursue, run after. So in this last stanza, what the poet wants to say, the watchman swings his lantern and walks with his shadow at his side. So he would move his lamp from one side to another. Okay, and his shadow was also visible on his side while he walked. Obviously, if there is a light, then you will be able to see your own shadow. So here, his shadow means watchman's shadow was also visible on his side while he was walking. And the child thought that the watchman would never have slept at night all his life. Okay, so here, the boy is thinking like about watchman, that he never sleeps in the night. And now he was wishing, the boy was wishing, I wish I were a watchman. So he wished that I were a watchman walking the street all night. Okay, and chasing the shadows with my lantern. And the child was so attracted to his moves that he wished to be a watchman who could walk all night in the streets, running after his shadows with the lantern in hand. Okay, dear students, only because of three persons were moving freely, okay, and there was nobody to stop them, only because of these qualities, the schoolboy got attracted. And firstly, he wanted to be a hawker, because hawker has no boundation of time and any other thing. Secondly, he wanted to be a gardener, because the gardener can do anything with the dust and the gardening tools. And at the last, he wanted to be a watchman, because during the night, the watchman is completely free to move from here to there. So, dear students, I hope you all have understood the vocation poem, and yes, you came to know about the main theme of the poem. So thank you so much. Keep learning till the next topic.